Hello friends, today we are going to discuss the geography for civil service exam. As we discussed earlier, we have launched course for daily important articles from newspaper. On the other hand, we have launched the various editorial analysis program of various Hindu, PIB and other newspapers. In Hindi medium, we have launched a series in which we are discussing Amar Ujala, NBT, Hindustan, Jansatta and all of the important articles. And you must go through the playlist so that you can be updated with our upcoming program. See, we are in the English medium, we are going to launch a series in which we are going to discuss PIB, the Hindu Indian Express, Times of India, Hindustan Times, Live Mint Business and all of the other articles that are relevant for your UPSC civil service exam. So friends, as I mentioned that in Hindi medium we have already launched the series and we have released our first video, so we are going to launch further videos on it. Daily we are going to release a current affair video in which we will be discussing all the important editorials. So friends, please go through it. So friends, today as we promised to you, we have launched the geography for civil service exam, that is a basic course. We will be launching a soon advanced course. Today we are going to discuss the some of the basics things in which we are going to discuss what is geography and all, how it is trending and all. So as we mentioned, we have launched a series on Hindi Sahitya Vaikalpik Vishay, that is Hindi literature optional subject. We are going to launch soon this series. If you are eager to see this series live as early as possible, so please share our channel, please subscribe our channel. As much as you can share, please share it. So friends, let us start our today's course, that is geography for civil service exam. How to prepare, what is the trend and how you can qualify exam with UP IAS. So let's discuss the friends, we are going to cover some of the important videos in which we are going to discuss how to prepare for geography for civil service exam. On the other hand, seasons of the earth, Coriolis force, we are going to discuss latitudinal air circulation, El Nino, ocean current, wind, climatic types, Indian monsoon, Indian vegetation and natural disaster vulnerability in India. See friends, these all are the important topics in which every aspirant have their doubts. Even though when we were preparing for civil service exam, we were also having doubts on these sessions, especially if you talk about El Nino, if you talk about the ocean current, if you talk about the wind climatic types, if you talk about Indian monsoon vegetation. These all are very very confusing topics and we are going to launch important series on all these important topics which you are having very much doubts. So friends, well, let's have the trend analysis. Number of questions we are going to analyze in geography section C. In 2007 we were having 19 questions, and in 2008 the trend goes up to 24, then another in 2009 it came to down to 19, then 21 in 2010. And see friends, the graph is going up and down. The recent year from 2015, 16 and 17, you can see in 15 the graph was to 16 question, after it came down to minimum 3 question, and now it is in 2017 it has been gone to 7 question, and 2018 it has again gone up. So you can't say that you any subject in the UPSC is going to be a path breaker to you, but friends, you can say that here you can see that the graph is going up and down. So any subject can't be neglected in the UPSC civil service exam. You have to be a generalist, you don't need to be a specialist in this. So see, we have divided the question into chapter wise. See, the universe, this is the first topic of ours, today's discussion, that 2015, 16, 17, you can see a total number of 6 questions have been covered. This is our first lecture on universe that will help you basically to qualify the prelims. It is a 6 question have been asked so far from the universe, so we are going to cover in this session what is universe. So friends, let us discuss the first chapter, that is what is universe. So let us discuss what is the origin of the universe. The universe was found from about 13.77 billion year ago, and our planet was formed 4.5 billion year ago. You can see the earth is much younger and is formed about 4.5 billion year ago. So friends, the universe, how it origin, the important points are the age of universe, the age of origin of earth. Please have a copy and pen and note down these important points. So friends, the origin of universe is still a theory or still a mystery for the people who pursue the climatological and geomorphological studies. So the Big Bang theory was initially the first path breaking theory which explained how the universe was formed. See, the universe, the most acceptable theory regarding this was the Big Bang theory. It is also called expanding universe hypothesis, which was given by Edward Hubble in 1920, that gave the universe is expanding. See, basically it says the universe origin was from a pinpoint. Here you can see here that we will see, wait a minute, see the universe origin from here and it expanded like anything, like this. It started expanding from to all direction. It started expanding and today the form of universe is the expanded form of universe which we see today. I'll show you another diagram for it. See, you can see here you can see the matter is in condensed form. See, the matter is in condensed form. It is expanding, and here it is. Here we are. The universe has expanded till here. You understood what the basic concept of expanding universe is? It says that the universe started from a pinpoint and it expanded like anything. Like today, the universe is expanding. Now the question that arises in your mind is how the universe is expanding and what are the theories and what are the evidence given through it. The Big Bang theory have considered the following points in development of universe. See, what are the points that have been considered? It is that all matter in the universe existed in one place in form of compact ball of compact matter with unambiguously small volume. See what it says, it was very small pinpoint volume which I initially said it is expanded. You understood what I am saying? I think you are getting it. So the compact ball exploded violently and continued and due to continuous contraction, see here it is having contraction, the huge expulsion is popularly known as Big Bang. See what happened, the point, the mass was contracting like this. It contracted, every mass was condensing here in the center point, the mass condensed and thus you can see the mass which condensed and ultimately a point came where it exploded to all direction, that I said it exploded and the universe formed. As a result of explosion, universe is continuously expanding. That is the argument supported by the phenomenon of redshift. See, redshift, it is very important question that UPSC has asked many times. Let us discuss what is redshift. Redshift, the frequency of wave appear to be higher when the source approaches to the observer. See what it is saying, the frequency of wave is higher when it approaches to the observer, it is lower when the source move away from the observer. The spectrum of visible light is red, has lowest frequency and wavelength, while the violet has the highest, shortest wavelength. So what you understand from these three points, that the in the spectrum of light, the lowest frequency and the longest wavelength is having by the visible light. On the other hand, the violet has highest frequency and shortest wavelength. You understood what I am saying? So it was observed that light coming from distant glaciers shift towards the red end of the spectrum. This shift was called as redshift. You see the pattern that is Wibgeur, in which the red comes, red is at the last, Wibgeur. So the moving from violet to red is called as redshift. See, violet to red, shortest frequency, highest frequency with shortest wavelength towards the red is known as the redshift. The redshift of the light is emerging from the galaxies prove that the galaxies are moving away from each other. See, what it basically says, when our observer is here, when it start moving away from the observer, see, it is V, it is R. So the violet color, when you will see from here, it will first appear violet if it is close to you. When it is here, it will appear red. That is called redshift. The color will be available, it will be red, because it is having last sequence in the Vibhor series. So you understood the basic concept. The red will be observed when the object is moving away from you, the observer. If the object is moving away from the observer, it will be appearing red. So that is called the basic phenomenon of redshift. So how we say the universe is expanding? If universe is expanding, the things start moving apart. That will appear if I am observing from here, the point A, then universe will appear red, means the point of light will appear to be red. That shows that there is a redshift and expansion of universe. Then there came the oscillating universe. It says that the universe was built on Big Bang theory. It says the state of expansion because of the force generated due to Big Bang explosion. However, the theory predicts when magnitude is repulsive force account for Big Bang. When lesser gravitational pull matter about 29 million years ago, the matter would again start from moving towards the center of universe. There will be another Big Bang. This process of contraction and expansion will continue forever. So what basically it is saying, let me tell you. I'll take a pen here. So see what it says. It says the universe is basically built on Big Bang theory. Okay, the state of expansion because it is generated is due to the Big Bang. The magnitude of repulsive force on account of Big Bang is lesser than the gravitational pull. See, gravitational pull after 29 million years ago, and it will start towards the center, means initial point it expanded and it will start again contracting towards the center, and again it will cause a Big Bang, means first it will expand and then it will start contracting. Here it will condense and ultimately the mass will become too bulky and it will again explode. That will cause another Big Bang. So you understood the basic concept. Now let us understand the final part of the series, of this first series, that is component of universe, celestial bodies, galaxy. What let us understand what are the basic terminologies. Galaxies, star, constellation. A galaxy is congregation of million of star held together by the gravitational force. Our galaxy is called as Milky Way. Understood? Means million of star aggregated together is known as galaxy. Understood the basic concept. The star generates its energy light through the process of fusion, which is lighter than element, particularly hydrogen, etc. Sun and Polaris are the popular stars. So what basically you can say, the star is a celestial body which derives its energy from fusion and nuclear fusion and fission. So it is called as a star. You understood what is star? So constellation, the group of star into different shapes is called as constellation. So I'll show you another diagram what the constellation is. The constellation you can see like this. You can see a warrior like structure in the sky that you may have heard Saptarishi and various other things that the nakshatras keep changing and they determine the human action. So basically they say about the constellations. They are the constellation. Okay, you understood the concept of constellation. So let's discuss another point. 2-3 points are left in this. Let's discuss them. So see, Polaris, it is commonly known as North Star or Pole Star, means Polaris or the Pole Star. It means The Dhruv Tara in Hindi. It is located on the poles, and it is situated. It appears to be the stationary in every time. It appears to be stationary. You might have listened in the Puranas and Vedas if you have heard that the Dhruv was given highest place in the universe. So it is the only star which appears to be stationary. So you understood? You can relate it with the Puranas and you will be able to learn. See how we can relate the current with our ancient past. That is the best way to study and that is the best way to qualify this exam. So what it basically says, the position of the star is not permanent. What I said, it is permanent but not always. After 26,000 years, when the earth completes its entire cycle, it will change its position and another star will take its position. So see, the Dhruv Tara will change, means the Dhruv Tara will be changing, but there will always be a Dhruv Tara. You understood? The star will be there, that will always exist, but the star may change. The celestial body may change, but its position would be stable there. So static polar star, formation of galaxies and star. Galaxies start form from the accumulation of hydrogen, growing nebula. Formation of the star is believed to be taken from 5 million to 6 billion year ago. So the last point we are going to discuss, meteors and shooting star. A meteor is a shooting star, flash fires the chunk of debris that to be noted as meteor, the fire flash debris itself. So you understood what is meteor? The meteor is the shooting star which enters the earth atmosphere, and when it comes inside the earth, when it reaches the surface and the debris is received, it is called as, when it will be here, it will meteor. When it will be reached on the surface, it will be called as meteoroid. So basically the point is that when it is in the atmosphere, it is meteor, and when it reaches the surface of the earth, it becomes meteoroid. Understand the basic concept? If any part of the meteoroid survive to fall on the earth land, and it is called as a meteoroid. So you understood? The majority of the meteoroid are very small in size, but it can be 100 kg or even more. So it's the basic question for you, which is the latest mission launched by NASA in this regard to have celestial body of a star controlled, and which star is going to strike the earth in the near future. You have to find out in the series. And now let us discuss a few questions regarding what we have discussed till now. So your practice question number one, a meteoroid is a comet with a bright gaseous tail. You can pause the video and comment the answers in the section. We will provide the answers at the last of the video. A comet with bright gaseous tail, a piece of matter that burns and get converted into earth atmosphere, outer space, a piece of matter that does not burn completely and reaches the surface of the earth, and none of the above. Now you have to give me the answer. I have discussed whatever was there. You have to give the answer. So we will be showing the answer at the end of video. Please comment in the section that rather you got or not. What is the difference between the asteroid and comet? Asteroid are formed. So let's discuss the answers. The asteroid are formed between the Mars and Jupiter, whereas the comets in the outer fringes of the solar system. The asteroid are gaseous in nature, whereas comets are not. Comets are a tail of asteroid also. So what you have to see, A is correct, B is correct, C is correct. You would be surprised how they came here. We have not discussed that asteroid, Kepler belt and all. So we are going to discuss this, but it's the basic question which we have to put here. Which of the following statement is true about the universe? Our universe is in the state of expansion. The light waves are used in to study different universe. Sound waves are used to measure the bodies. Now you have to see the questions 2 and 3, 1 and 2, 1 only, 1, 2 and 3. Which of the following, now the fourth question and the last question, I think. Consider the following statement. Comet has highly elliptical orbit that brings them close to the sun. Often it beyond the Pluto. That is the first option. Solar wind is responsible for the formation of tails and comets. One only, two only, both one and two and three only. You have to find out the questions. So you think about it. I'll show the question just in a few seconds. See, the answer for the first is C, second is B, third is B and four is C. Let's see. First question is C. What is C? C option is this. A meteoroid is a piece of matter that does not burn completely and reaches the earth's surface. So see what we have discussed earlier. What is meteor? Meteor is a part that falls on the earth unburnt, is known as meteor C. Okay, we discussed it. Now, what is the difference between asteroid and meteoroid? It is B part. 1 and 3. So we have also discussed this. Now the third part, we are not lengthening the session now. B, the answer is B. B is 1 and 2 only. You must see it from the previous. You can go back and see what we have done, the explanation. And now the fifth and fourth question we will talk about. It is, the answer is C. C is both 1 and 2. Okay, so see, go back and see whatever you have seen. So I like to say that the Cengage PrepMed book series are supporting us, and the content here used is solely used from them, and they have provided a much help to us in making this series and making the basic series for the geography. You can, if you feel good, you can see this series. And we are going to the Hindi medium students always ask that which book to study, and we are going to launch soon the what books you should study for the UPSC civil service exam. You must go through that video to have a clear idea, but you can prefer these books as these are prepared by us expert team, and they have tried to cover each and every point regarding your UPSC civil service exam. So you must go through them. So friends, that's all for the day, and you please comment the answers of these questions, how many questions you were been able to solve, and how you felt our series. Are our courses very useful for you? Please do share, subscribe and comment, as you want the Hindi Sahitya series, so you have to comment. Business Standard Hindi, the Hindu analysis, if you want, you have to ask us, because as it has been said that the mother don't feed the children until it cries. So please do comment, do share, do subscribe, and soon please wait for our upcoming videos. And we are soon going to launch the video series on different topics. So be prepared and be patient. We will help you to BIS, and we will help you to achieve your goal. So thank you friends. Please like, share and comment, and how you like the videos, please share them.